Please do all.
让我们一起来念今天早上的经文，讲题好吗？比较长。
Read the title together.
一二三，你为什么笑得这么灿烂呢？这个讲题到底在说什么呢？先给大家看一张照片。
Now what is this title about? I shall first of all let you see a photo.
照片里的这个家伙是不是长得很帅啊？
Now isn't this a handsome young lad?
这是我在中国服侍的时候拍的一张照片。
Now this was a picture of me when I was serving in China.
我笑得很灿烂，是吧？
And I was smiling very brightly, am I not?
但是这张照片和这个讲题一点关系也没有。
But this photo has nothing to do with the title.
那这个讲题到底在说什么呢？且听我细细道来。
So what is the title of today's morning about? Let me explain.
去年2022年对我来说是很不好过的一年。
Now last year, 2022 was a difficult year for me.
一年里发生了许许多多大大小小不如意的事情。
For in that year, many big and small unpleasant things happened to me.
那些事情都是接踵而来的。
And they come one after the other.
有时候我还真感到压得被压得喘不过气来。
And sometimes I feel so pressured that I cannot breathe.
开始的时候是苏大嫂罹患了失智症。
Now at first is that I found out that my wife had dementia.
虽然她的病情还只是处在初步的阶段。
Even though her dementia is still in the initial phase.
但是两个人的生活习惯都需要做出很大很多的调整。
But two person living together, we need to make huge adjustments to the way we live.
其中一个最大的改变。
Now one of the major changes.
就是我不能再出远门服事。
Is that I can no longer go a distant places to serve.
就连在新加坡的讲道次数也都得削减了。
Even the frequency of my preaching in Singapore itself is reduced.
再也不能像过去那样每个主日都上讲台。
Now no longer can I every Sunday go up to the pulpit to preach.
我得花更多的时间陪苏大嫂。
I need to spend more time taking care of my wife.
这一点我是欣然接受的。
But I still accept this point.
只要她的病情不再恶化。
Now as long as her sickness do not deteriorate.
要我怎么照顾她都行。
I can take care of her anyways.
因为她是我最爱的人了。
Because I love her the most.
只是我自己也得有个健康的身体。
But I myself as a caretaker, I need to be healthy as well.
我不能倒下，我倒下了，她要怎么办呢？
I cannot fall, for if I fall, what will happen to her?
我要怎么照顾她呢？
How should I take care of her?
所以我平日的祷告就是求主保守我的身体健康。
So my daily prayers is only that God take care of my health.
而我每一年的体检结果都是不错的。
And every year my health checkup has turned out well.
可是没有想到去年的五月。
But who knows, last year, May.
我体检的结果却出现了一点问题。
Now something came up in my medical checkup.
长话短说，医生发现我可能需要接受一个叫做大肠内窥镜的手术。
Now to summarize, the doctor advised me saying that I need to do a certain colonoscopy.
看看里头，我里头有没有息肉，这个致癌的东西。
Now to see if there be any malignant tumors within my body.
这个手术我七年前是做过的。
Now I did this surgery 7 years ago.
手术的结果发现那里并没有息肉。
Now the surgery results turned out it was good, there was nothing there.
七年过去了。
Now 7 years passed.
如今需要再动一次这样的手术也是非常合理的。
Now today I need to do this surgery again is reasonable to me.
可是也就是在这个时候。
But in this particular time.
我的心情越来越沉重了。
Now my mood, I felt very heavy.
我想的事情越来越多了。
I think I have so much things on my hands.
万一我真的有事以至于失去了照顾苏大嫂的能力。
Now in case that I really have something about my health, then who will take care of her?
那么两个人下来的日子要怎么过？
And how should the days be before us, for the both of us?
我们是相依为命的两个人。
Now we depend living on each other.
她要怎么照顾我，我又要怎么照顾她。
How does she take care of me, and how can I take care of her?
而在等待动手术的那段日子。
So upon waiting for the surgery.
偏偏又发生了很多大大小小，我都得去处理的事情。
And yet every day it continues to happen, big and small things that I need to do.
有时候事情太多了，我都不知道要怎么跟常为我祷告的弟兄姐妹说。
Now sometimes I have so many things on my hands that I don't know how to tell those who are praying for me.
渐渐的我发现我失去了一样东西。
Now gradually, I realized I lost something.
喜乐。
Joy.
我的信心还行。
Now I still have faith.
可是喜乐却渐渐的不见了，离我远去了。
But I found that joy has departed from me.
特 特别是在手术过后，当那位女医生跟我说
，Especially after the surgery, the female doctor said to me，
我肠胃那里发现有五粒的息肉。
That in my intestines I found five malignant tumors.
其中没有大碍的四粒已经切除。
Four of it are benign and they have been removed.
但是有一粒比较大的需要怎么处理
？But one of it is pretty huge and how should I deal with it？
医院会安排我见另外一位大医生。
So the hospital recommended me to see another doctor.
我的心更往下沉了。
And then that sunk my heart.
这表示问题还没有解决。
Because the problem is still not solved.
如果那粒上面切割的息肉是恶性的
，Now if that tumor is to be removed, it's malignant.
我也得看病，也得接受治疗的话
，I need to receive treatment and all this.
那我要怎么好好的照顾苏大嫂呢
？Then how can I take care of my wife?
过了不久，我见到了一位我从来没有见过的医生。
Now not long after, I met a doctor I've never met before.
奇妙的事情发生了。
A wonderful thing happened.
不知道为什么
I don't know why.
我一见着这位 Dr. Tan,
when I first met this Dr. Tan,
心里就有一种腓立比书那里所说的出人意外的平安。
In my heart, I experienced a kind of amazing peace, just like in Philippians.
一种莫名的说不上来的平安，要说是喜乐也可以。
Now a peace or joy that transcends all understanding.
眼前的这位 Dr. Tan, 我一见着他，我就很喜欢他。
When I saw this Chen 医生 right before me, I loved him.
他跟我说 ，Mr. Saul， 我们还得要动一次的手术。
Now he said to me that I used to need to do one more surgery.
把那粒的息肉切除下来。
To remove that tumor from you.
拿去化验是良性的还是恶性的
？And then to find out whether it's benign or malignant.
如果是良性的，那最好。
Now if it's benign, then all good.
是恶性的话，我们再想办法，好吗
？But if it's malignant, then we need to do something about it.
我问他，请问是您？帮我动的这个手术吗
？So I asked him, "Are you the one who are to do this surgery for me?"
Dr. Tan 说是的。
Dr. Tan said yes.
我马上说那没问题，再动一次手术好了。
And I replied saying, "Okay, no problem, do it again."
那一刹那，我心里清楚得很。
Now at that time, I was so clear in my mind.
眼前的这位 Dr. Tan 是神差派来的。
That this doctor was a gift from God.
我对他很有信心。
I had full confidence in this doctor.
要不然我心中不可能有那样的平安。
Now, if not, my heart wouldn't experience such peace.
Dr. Tan 给我动手术，我放120个心。
Now, if this doctor does the surgery for me, I can rest my heart.
然后在和他接下去的谈话中
，And as I continue to converse with him,
我无意中聊起我的信仰。
Now, by accident, I mentioned about my faith.
我说我是基督徒。
That I am a Christian.
Dr. Tan 忽然也说了这么一句：“我也是基督徒。”
And Dr. Tan also said, "I am also a Christian."
我心里马上咯噔了一下。
And in my heart, there was a chord that was struck.
我说呢，我心里怎么会有那么大的平安
？And so I say, "Why is it that I can experience so much peace?"
主啊，原来是你把 Dr. Tan 领到我的面前了。
I said to the Lord that it is you who have brought this doctor before me.
就在那天，就在那个时候。
At that moment, in that day,
喜乐又涌入我的心头，重回到我的身上。
Now joy filled my heart once again.
今年的一月三号。
Now this year, January the 3rd.
当护士们把我推进手术室的时候
，When the nurses pushed me into the operating theater,
我虽然已经摘下眼镜，看不清周围的环境。
Although I've taken down my spectacles and I could not see clearly,
但是我清楚地看到了站在那里等着我的 Dr. Tan.
But I saw clearly with my own eyes Dr. Tan waiting for me.
我跟他说 Happy New Year.
And I wished him Happy New Year.
他也微笑着祝我新年快乐。
And he responded with a smile and wished me likewise.
我心里头平静得很。
And in my heart, I experienced great peace.
麻醉师很快地出现在我的眼前。
The anesthetist appeared before me.
当他把麻醉药注入我体内之后
，When he or she put the anesthesia in my body，
我笑着跟他说 Good night，
and I smiled to her, him or her saying Good night，
就沉沉入睡了
，and I fell into a sleep。
之后发生了什么事情，我全不知道。
And afterwards, what happened, I really do not know.
等到我睁开双眼的时候
，Until I opened my eyes，
我发现我已经离开了手术室，回到我的病床上。
I found that I'm sleeping on a bed in a ward.
我知道手术已经完成了，感谢主。
And I knew that at that moment the surgery has been completed. Thank the Lord.
而我发现我身体竟然没有任何的不适。
And there's no such thing as any uncomfortableness in my body.
我知道手术是成功的。
So I knew that the surgery went well.
过了半个小时吧。
After half an hour,
我听见从不远处传来 Dr. Tan 的声音了。
Now from not too far came the voice of Dr. Tan.
我知道他来看我了。
I know he came to see me.
我笑脸相迎。
So with a smile, I greeted him.
他一见着我。
And when he saw me,
就用他很爽朗的声音问我。
Now with his very generous voice, he said,
你怎么笑得这么灿烂啊？
Now how is it you can smile so brightly?
我们都笑了。
And so we all laughed.
弟兄姐妹之下，你知道我今天这个讲题的出处了吧？
So now, brothers and sisters, do you know where I got my title from now?
我真是喜乐呀，弟兄姐妹。
For indeed, I'm filled with joy.
Dr. Tan 说手术很顺利，叫我放心。
Now Dr. Tan said the surgery is a success, so rest your case.
他会再见我，告诉我息肉拿去化验之后的结果。
And you tell me again the results of the tumor.
不知道为什么那一刻我心里已经知道结果会是什么。
But I'm not sure why, but at that moment, I already know what the result will be.
一个月后 ,Dr. Tan 果然是这么说的。
One month later, Dr. Tan said to me,
Mr. So, 放心是良性的。
He said to me, rest assured, it is benign.
我没事了。
So I'm okay.
我担忧的事情全没发生。
And all the things that I worried about did not happen.
一切的颂赞全归于主。
So all praise and glory be to God.
Dr. Tan 的这句话我超喜欢。
So I love what Dr. Tan said to me then.
我当下做了两个决定。
At that time, I resolved two things in my heart.
一个是我要把他这句话作为讲题写一篇讲章。
The one thing is that I resolved to make this sentence that he said into a sermon, a title.
你现在听到的这篇信息就是这么来的。
So this message that I'm hearing this morning came like this.
还有一个是我当晚就跟几位好朋友分享了 Dr. Tan 说的这句话。
And then also the other thing that I resolved is to share this thing that this doctor shared to me.
没有想到马上引起了一位弟兄的回应。
And who knows, immediately invited a response from a brother.
他说苏大哥你为什么笑得这么灿烂的这句话
He said, dear brother, this statement, why are you smiling so brightly?
也就是三十多年前我在远东福音广播公司第一次见到你认识你的时候心里头的那句话
It is the statement that I wanted to say to you many years ago when I was working in Far East organization.
你当时脸上露出的笑容是那么的灿烂
At that time when I see you smile, it is that bright.
我在想这位弟兄怎么能够这么喜乐呢
Now I must be thinking, how is this brother so happy?
我当时好羡慕你啊苏大哥
So at that time, I was so envious of you, brother Su.
没想到三十多年过去了
Now, to think that 30 odd years have passed.
在别人的眼里你还是那么喜乐的一个人
In the eyes of others, they saw the same thing that I saw in you.
可是
Yet,
我真的有那么喜乐吗
Am I really that joyful?
我真的有那么好吗
Am I really that good?
这是今天早上我要在这里检讨自己的一个问题。
This is a question I asked myself this morning.
没有。
No.
我没有那么好。
I'm not that good.
我没有那么喜乐。
I'm not that joyful.
我还差得远。
I'm far from that.
众人可能都觉得我是一个喜乐的人。
Many people may think that I'm a very joyful person.
有时候我自己也的确是这么想的。
Sometimes I thought myself too, like this.
可是我在想呢。
But I thought.
在主耶稣那里，在这一方面，我可能还是一个不及格的人。
And in the eyes of Jesus Christ, perhaps I'm still a failure.
所以今天早上，我想以罗马书五章一到五节来做个测试。
So today, as a litmus test, I choose this passage, Romans chapter 5.
看看我在这一方面是否够得上主耶稣的标准，是否及格。
To see whether I pass the test in the eyes of our Lord Jesus.
我们可以开始来看今天早上的这一段讲患难的经文了。
Let's take a look at this passage about trials.
罗马书第五章第一节，我们既因信称义，就借着我们的主耶稣基督得与神相合。保罗说，我们得救，我们能与神和好。
Now Paul said that we have been saved and we can be reconciled with God.
全是靠主耶稣基督在十字架上为我们所成就的救恩。
It's all by the merits of the salvation that Jesus has wrought for us on the cross.
也凭着神所赐给我们的信心。
And also by the faith that God has given us.
第二节，我们又借着他因信得进入现在所站的这恩典中，并且欢欢喜喜盼望神的荣耀。 我们这些蒙恩得救的人
Then verse 2 says that for us who have been saved by grace,
非但能够享有这么大的恩典
that we can have such a great grace,
还能欢欢喜喜地等候永生
we can still rejoice of the hope of eternal life,
以及主的再来
as well as the coming of the Lord.
第三节不单如此，就是在患难中也是欢欢喜喜的，因为知道患难生忍耐。马上来到我们要思想的患难了。
And verse 3, rejoice in our sufferings and sufferings perseverance. It comes to trials.
不但如此，这句话明明地指出，信了主耶稣，不但能够与神和好。
So this verse tells us that when we believe in Jesus, we can be reconciled with God.
叫我们欢喜快乐。
That we can rejoice and be joyful.
也是要遇上患难的。
But more so, we will meet with sufferings.
而在患难中，我们也得要欢欢喜喜的。
And yet in our sufferings, we should be joyful.
保罗的这句话似乎不合情理。
Now, what Paul said here may seem unreasonable.
因为第一，有谁愿意落在患难之中呢？
Because first of all, who wants to be in suffering?
第二，患难有什么值得我们欢喜快乐的呢？
Secondly, what is so happy or joyful about suffering?
但这就是保罗在这里所指出的真理，值得我们好好的思考。
But here's the truth that the Apostle Paul wrote for us to think about.
我们继续看第三节。
Let's look at verse 3.
不但如此，就是在患难中也是欢欢喜喜的。我常常在想。
So not only so, but we also rejoice in our sufferings. I often think.
如果基督徒在决志之前有人这样的告诉我们。
Now before a person believes in Jesus, someone should tell him.
你信主之后的日子不一定好过。
That after you believe in Jesus, you may not be very good in your days.
不只是能够享有喜乐平安而已。
Not only will you have joy and peace,
还要因信主的缘故吃很多的苦头，为主受苦。
But when you believe in Jesus, you suffer for the Lord.
弟兄姐妹，不知道你还会不会要信主？
Then will you still believe in Jesus?
还会不会要受洗？
Will you still want to be baptized?
不但要受苦，圣经这里还要求受苦的人还得是欢欢喜喜的。
Not only to suffer, but to rejoice in sufferings.
这真是奇了怪了，在患难中也要欢喜。
Now that is so strange that as our sufferings we should rejoice.
患难中怎么可能会欢喜？
How can we rejoice in suffering?
哪有可能？
How is it possible?
可是圣经在这里就是这么要求我们的。
But such is what the Bible requires of us here.
所以这个时候我们需要在这里稍微停下来。
So over here, we'll stop our footsteps for a while.
借着另外一卷书的一处的经文来帮助我们了解。
That from another passage, perhaps we can help to understand this.
为什么患难中要喜乐？
Why do we rejoice in our suffering?
请翻到雅各书第一章二到四节。
So turn to James chapter 1, verse 2 to 4.
我们要先来了解为什么信主之后一定有患难在哪儿等着我们。
So we now come to understand why is it after believing in Jesus, there are sufferings waiting for us.
患难的意义又何在？
And what is the point of sufferings?
答案都可以在这三节的经文里找得到。
And the answer could be found in James, these three verses.
我的弟兄们，你们落在百般试炼中，都要以为大喜乐，因为知道你们的信心经过试验，就生忍耐。但忍耐也当成功，使你们成全完备，毫无缺欠。当年读雅各这封书信的基督徒
Now at that time, the Christians who read this letter of James
散居在各地
Now they were spread out across the land
他们不信主还好
They do not believe in Jesus
信了主马上就面临各样的逼迫了
But once they believe, they face all kinds of trials
落在百般试炼中的这个落在百般试炼中可有意思了
Now this, whenever you face trials of many kinds, it means something
其实在原文里这句话的前面是有每当这个字的。
So in original language, there is a whenever.
我的弟兄们，每当你们落在百般试炼中。
So my brothers, whenever you face trials of many kinds.
什么叫每当？
What does it mean whenever?
每当的意思就是这件事情是一定会发生的。
Whenever means it will happen.
每当不是如果。
Whenever is not if.
是绝对会有，绝对会发生的事情。
It means certainly, for sure, it will happen.
而不是或许会有，或许不会有的事情。
And does not mean if or if not.
唐朝的诗人王维 写过一首叫做《九月九日忆山东兄弟》的诗。
So a person one wrote a poem.
我们一起来念。
So we shall read this poem together.
好吧。
On the screen.
我们一起来念。
Let's read this together.
你们的华文都很好的。
So your Mandarin should be pretty good.
一二三，
独在异乡为异客，
每逢佳节倍思亲。遥知兄弟登高处，遍插。哦，不会念了，少一人啊。这两个字我们不会念是吧？
We don't know how to pronounce that last two words.
我们不会念的时候总是嘚嘚就过去了。
So we just pass by.
这两个字念茱萸。
茱萸 is pronounced.
是一种香草 ，a herb.
A kind of herb.
遥知兄弟登高处，遍插茱萸少一人。九月九日是重阳节。
So the 9th of September is a certain festival.
重阳节是中国民间的传统节日。
Now this festival in China is a traditional tradition.
就在农历九月九日。
It's in the lunar calendar 9th of September.
古人相信重阳节去爬山的时候。
Now the ancients believed that as they go up to the mountains on this day,
只要插上茱萸这种的香草。
As long as they put on this herb,
是能辟邪的。
Then it can ward off evil.
这年的重阳节，王维在异乡做客。
So on this day, the person who wrote this poem was there as a guest.
这天，他想念他老家的老弟了。
At this moment, he was thinking and missing his brother at his hometown.
他说：“今天是重阳节，弟弟爬山去了吧？”
He said, "Today is this Chongyang festival, and my brother has gone up the mountain."
想必他心中一定会感慨：“怎么就少了我一个人呢？”
He must be thinking of me as well.
佳节总是特别容易叫我们思乡，是吧？
Now, whenever it comes to this festival, will make us think of our home.
所以王维特别的感慨。
So this poet Wang Wei, he felt great moving.
每逢佳节倍思亲。
Now every festive, you think about his home.
什么叫每逢
？So what is 每逢？
每逢就是每每的意思，每一年来到重阳节的意思。
It means every year when it comes to this Chongyang festival.
同样的，雅各说，每逢你们落在试炼中，意思也是一样的。
In the same way, and James said, whenever.
那就是对基督徒来说，信主之后是一定要遇上试炼的。
That is, after you become a Christian, you will meet with trials.
这是免不了的一件事。
It cannot be prevented.
试炼会在你信主之后，团团的把你围住。
And trials will surround you after you believe in Jesus.
你们落在百般试炼中的落在这个字也很有意思。
And much meaning also to the word face, trials, face.
就是被敌人团团围住的意思。
Now it means to be surrounded by enemies.
我们爱看的华语古装武侠片。
Now sometimes we see this Chinese drama about kung fu and martial arts.
就出现不少这样的场面。
And then such a scene would come about.
为父亲报仇的男主角来到一个没有人的地方。
Now the male character came for revenge for his father, came to a desolate place.
忽然发现杀父仇人带着一帮人出现在他的眼前。
And suddenly saw his enemies, arch enemy, come with a company of people.
把他团团围住。
And then surrounded him.
然后仰天大笑。
And then he laughed to the sky.
哈哈哈哈哈哈哈哈。
And ha ha ha.
小子，我看你往哪儿逃。
So, see where shall you escape now?
我算过了，这种时候杀父仇人的仰天大笑都是八次的。
So I counted this kind of scenes.
试炼也会在我们信主之后找上我们。
So trials in like this will come to us, surround us.
把我们团团围住。
And surround us in our lives.
你躲不过的。
And you cannot escape this.
所以我们不免要问。
So we can't help but ask a question.
为什么会有失恋呢？
Why are there trials?
为什么会有患难呢？
Why are there difficulties?
为什么遇上失恋和患难的时候都要欢欢喜喜的呢？
Why is it we must rejoice in trials and sufferings?
雅各书这里不也是有话这么说的吗？
Now isn't what James say something over here?
我的弟兄们，你们落在百般失恋中都要以为大喜了。
My brothers, when you face all trials of all kinds,Consider it pure joy.
我们继续看雅各书第一章第三、第四节。
Let us continue to look at verse 3 and verse 4.
这两节经文告诉我们
，These two verses tell us，
我们在试炼中要是能靠着主所加的力量忍耐的话
，But by the strength of the Lord added to us, if we can endure it，
就能达到神借着患难锻炼我们的目的。
Then he can achieve the objective of these trials that God has given us.
那就是使你们成全完备，毫无缺欠。什么叫使你们成全完备？
That we can be mature and complete. What does it mean, mature and complete?
原来试炼是要叫我们的属灵生命越来越成长。
So trials came so that our spiritual life can be more and more mature.
越来越能够蒙神悦纳。
And then to be more and more acceptable to the Lord.
毫无缺欠。
And to be not lacking anything.
神要我们的属灵生命全面的发展。
Now God wants our spiritual life to grow in all aspects.
以致没有哪一方面哪一角是有缺陷的。
Such that there is not one aspect of our spiritual life that is lacking.
主耶稣知道我们的属灵生命哪一方面还不够好。
Now Jesus knows which aspect in our spiritual life is lacking.
于是他会继续地用试炼来锻炼我们。
Therefore, He will give us trials to train us, to mold us.
好叫我们的属灵生命更为成熟，更为丰满。
So that we can grow more mature and full in our spiritual life.
用很具体的话来说。
So in very explicit words, specific words.
就是要我们活得更像主耶稣。
It's so that we can live more like our Lord Jesus Christ.
由于我们的生命不够好，不够美。
Because our life is still not perfect, not beautiful enough.
还不能荣耀神的名。
And cannot glorify God.
神也是借着种种的患难来熬炼我们。
Therefore, God used all kinds of trials to train us.
他要我们变得更有信心。
He wants us to grow in our faith.
更有爱心。
And to grow in our love.
更良善。
And to grow in our goodness.
更喜乐。
Grow in our joy.
更温柔。
Grow in our gentleness.
更顺服神的带领。
And grow in our submission to God.
更不容易发脾气。
And to grow in our temperance.
更能忍受恶劣的侍奉环境。
And to be able to accommodate all kinds of circumstances.
更能宽恕原谅别人的过犯。
To be more able to forgive the sins or offenses of others.
患难是带有重大的使命的。
Now trials have carried with them a great commission.
是要催逼我们的灵命成长的。
It is to force us to grow.
有句话是这么说的，我很喜欢。
Now, there's a saying that goes like this.
Life is like photography. You need the negatives to develop. 这是一句双关语。
So this is a kind of saying.
它表面的意思是。
Now what it means on the surface?
照片是经由底片 negative 冲洗出来的 develop.
Now the photos are developed from negatives.
这是这句话本来的意思。
Now this is the original meaning.
但他要说的不是这个。
But what it's trying to say is yet another meaning.
他要说的是
What he's trying to say?
对不起 Negative 在这里的另一个意思是不好的环境
So over here the negatives means bad circumstances
不顺的境遇
Or certain things, unpleasant things in life
放在我的这篇信息里那就是患难
So put it into my message today, it is trials
Develop 则是成长的意思
And develop means to grow
所以这句话的另外一个意思是
So another meaning for this saying,
生命是要经过磨难，慢慢的成长的。
Is that in life we need to go through sufferings to grow slowly and gradually.
属灵生命更是如此。
So much so our spiritual life.
7年前吧。
7 years ago.
我在北京教课。
I was teaching in Beijing.
班上有40-50位的学生。
In a class, there was 40 to 50 pupils.
一位学生上完课问我孙老师：“你能不能到我的城市那里去讲这门课？”
Now a student came up to me and asked, "Can you teach the same thing in my hometown?"
这种事经常都会在我教完第一天课之后发生。
Now this kind of things often happen to me after my first lesson.
有些学生会上前来邀请我到他们的那个地方去讲课。
Some students would come up to me and invite me to their own hometown over there to teach.
时间上配合得到的话。
And if time allows,
我通常都会接受邀请的。
Usually, I will accept the invite.
这位学生甚至还多加了一项要求。
Now, this student added another request.
邀请我在他服侍的城市教课之后。
And asked me that after I teach this lesson in his home,
也请我到他的老家去讲课。
And also, asked me to go and teach in his own hometown.
因为老家的弟兄姐妹都是农民。
Because in that, his hometown was a lot of farmers.
没有什么经济能力能够到城市来上课。
Now, they were not very financially blessed to go to cities to be taught.
由于时间上配合得到，我也答应了。
So, when my timing allows, I said yes.
第二年去到他们那里。
The second year, we went to a place.
休息了一个晚上。
And I rested at night.
第二天早上到了教会，我却发现。
Then the second, when the morning comes, I went to church. I realized.
除了传道人和我，就再也没有其他的人影了。
Now besides the preacher and me, there was no one else.
眼看上课的时间就快到了。
And seeing that the time for the lesson is about to start.
学生这个时候才跟我说。
And this time, the student told me.
老师，我看不会有人来了。
Teacher, I think no one is coming.
我问他，你是不是没有发出邀请？
Is it you have not sent out your request?
他支支吾吾地说，可能是这个时候我们这里还有其他的课程。
Oh, but perhaps he said he replied to me saying there are maybe other courses now.
他们都参加那些课程去了。
And they have gone to these other courses.
可是最叫我不能忍受的。
But what is it that I cannot take?
他在下来的那几天里，始终没有向我道歉。
Is that for the next following days after he did not apologize to me?
有一个晚上。
So one night,
我趁只有我们两个人在一起的时候。
Now when just the both of us were alone together,
按捺着我的怒气，我很生气。我按捺着我的怒气跟他说。
I was holding down my anger. I said to him,
你知道老师是自费来的，我自己出钱的。
Now you know that teacher me, I came by my own expenses.
老师来你这里一趟不容易。
Now it's not easy for me to come here.
老师可以用来你这里的机票和住宿费去帮助其他地方的弟兄姐妹。
I could have used these expenses spent for you and your hometown to in other places.
你猜我这名学生听完了之后他说什么？
And guess what? How this student replied to me?
他竟然轻描淡写的只说了这几个字。
And superficially said these words.
没事，没事。
It's okay, it's okay.
过了五天。
After 5 days.
他开车把我送去他老家了。
He drove me to his hometown.
你现在看到的这张图片很漂亮，是吧？
Now this photo that you see, beautiful, isn't it?
那两排的杨树我特别的喜欢。
Now these two rows of trees, I love it.
路的尽头就是学生的老家了。
And the student's hometown is right at the end of this road.
那是一个乡镇。
Over there is a small village.
很偏僻的地方。
A very suburban place.
我原是想住在酒店的。
So I wanted to live at first in a hotel.
学生说他们那儿没有酒店。
But the students say there are no hotels in that place.
老师，你住的地方我们都给你安排好了。
Teacher, but I have arranged for you your accommodation.
就住在一位弟兄的家。
So I stayed in a brother's house.
那个弟兄说，那个房子呢是他儿子的。
And that brother said that this house belonged to his son.
儿子去了大城市工作。
But his son has gone to the city to work.
已经空下来两三年了，没人住。
And has left this house empty for 2 or 3 years. No one lived there.
一进到那屋里。
When I first came to that house,
我差点没昏过去。
I almost fainted.
屋里的东西既没打扫，也没整理。
So they were full of dust and very messy.
全都是用大白布盖着，全都是灰尘。
Now everything was covered up with a white cloth and full of dust.
就连我要睡的那张床也只是用布盖着的。
Now even the bed that I was sleeping on, it was just covered by a cloth.
床单、枕头套什么的全没换洗。
On the pillows, pillowcases, all is unclean. It's dirty.
床前的小桌子也是白蒙蒙的，蒙了一层又一层的灰尘。
And the table before the bed also is dust and layers of dust.
而更吓人的是
what is more daunting?
弟兄跟我说
that the brother said to me,
厨房里的煤气炉坏了，老师你不能煮开水。
Now there's no more gas in the stove. You cannot boil water.
碗、筷子、杯子也都没有。
There are no bowls, no chopsticks whatsoever.
浴室里的花洒也坏了。
And even the shower head is spoiled.
老师，你不能洗澡。
Teacher, you cannot bathe.
不过还好，马桶还是可以用的。
But at least the toilet bowl is still usable.
弟兄姐妹，我当下的想法是。
Now, dear all, my thinking at that time.
这是待客之道吗？
Is this such a way to treat a guest?
我不要求什么。
I don't ask for much.
我只要求有一张干净的床铺。
All I ask for is a clean bed.
能用的碗盘茶杯。
Some usable cutleries.
能让我洗澡的浴室。
A place to shower.
可是主人家全不当一回事。
But in that house, none of this.
也没有一句道歉的话。
And again, no apology.
下来的那四五天里，我感谢主的是。
In the following days, well, I still thank God for one thing.
我的鼻子没事情。
That nothing happened to my nose.
因为平常的日子，我的鼻子是很敏感的。
Because usually my nose is especially sensitive.
要进来这么样一间布满灰尘的房子，早就伤风感冒了。
Now to come down to such a dusty house, I would have fallen ill with sneezes and cold.
第二，那几天非但没能洗澡。
So in that few days, when I didn't shower,
也不能煮 开水泡咖啡了。
Neither could I boil water to make my coffee.
所以弟兄姐妹，你知道五天过后我回到城市第一件做的事情是什么吗？
So you know, after 5 days, when I first returned back to the city, what was the first thing I did?
洗澡。
Shower.
错了，泡咖啡。
To boil coffee, to make my coffee.
这件事情就这样过去了。
So such a thing, pass on part of history.
我慢慢的也就淡忘了。
And I've forgotten about it.
我自然没有把这些不愉快的事情放在心上。
And I never placed these unpleasant things too long in my heart.
只是有时候想起来，还是真不明白为什么会遇上这么不顺心的事。
Is that sometimes when I think back about this, I would think, why is it I come to such, meet such an unpleasant circumstance?
直到有一天。
Now, one day, until one day, something happened.
主耶稣让我想到。
Now, the Lord Jesus, let me think.
某某人，你说你在那个小乡镇，你住的那个地方很肮脏，很不方便，是吧？
So you have complained about the dirtiness and inconvenience of living in that home.
那我降生在马槽里，马槽里的环境会比你住的那个地方好吗？
Now how about me, who was born in a manger?
还有，你说你的学生没有向你道歉。
Now you said that your student did not apologize to you.
亏欠了你。
And have leave you in debt.
那么当年我来这个世上的时候。
Now when I came to this world.
得罪我的人。
Have those who offended me.
顶撞我的人
have those who accused me,
亏欠我的人
have those who have done me wrong,
没向我道歉的人有多少
and how many are those really who did not apologize to me?
忽然间我明白了
Now suddenly I came to my senses.
那年的那一趟的服事为什么有那么多的不愉快
Now that year, why is it there's so much unpleasantness in my service?
因为我的属灵生命不够好
I realized it's because my spiritual life was poor.
因为我的属灵生命还差得远。
Because my spiritual life is still very far.
神还是得借着种种的不如意。
So God still need to use all kinds of unpleasantness.
磨练我。
To mold me.
锻炼我。
To train me.
提醒我。
To remind me.
孩子啊，你还是需要锻炼。
So God is saying to me, dear child, you still need to train.
你还是需要我的调教。
And you still need my growth to you.
有一句话我也非常的喜欢。
Now a saying, a quote I also like very much.
He who has a why to live for can bear almost any how. 我也好喜欢这句话。
So this saying, I love this quote very much.
这句话说的是。
Now what this quote is trying to say.
你要是能明白信主之后为什么要经历种种的患难。
Now if you could understand why you're going through so much trials after you believe in Jesus.
也就能够欢欢喜喜地忍受各样的患难了。
Then with great joy you will endure them.
我真是特别感谢神。
So I especially give thanks to God.
在今年初动完第二次的大肠内窥镜手术之后。
So beginning of this year, when I first finished that major surgery,
神借着 Dr. Tan 对我说的那句话。
Now through Dr. Tan, this statement that was said to me.
后来他见到了我，知道我要用这句话写一篇讲章。
And later on, I knew that I should write a message using this thing that he said to me.
他要求我写完之后录音给他听。
And after this message, he requested of me to put it on record and play it to him.
他已经听了这篇道了。
And he has already heard this message.
神借着 Dr. Tan 对我说的那句话。
And through Dr. Tan, what God has said to me then.
你为什么笑得那么灿烂呢？
Why are you smiling so brightly?
提醒了我。
It's a reminder to me.
我真的是那么喜乐的一个人吗？
Am I such really a joyful person?
我亲爱的弟兄姐妹。
Dear brothers and sisters.
我们既然知道信主的人受苦是难免的。
If we thus know that.It is inevitable that Christians go into trials.
主要我们受苦。
And God wants us to suffer.
乃是为了我们的好处。
But for our good.
那么下一回患难又临到的时候。
Then when trials one day shall come to you.
我们就不要再发怨言埋怨主了。
Let us not complain or hold grudge against God.
反倒要以笑脸迎接患难。
But rather face trials.With a smile.
因为知道眼前最长的患难就是为了提升我们的属灵生命来的。
For know for a certainty that the trial before you is to enrich you in your spiritual life.
经过患难的磨练。
And after these trials,
我们才有望一步步地走到属灵生命的高峰。
You can have hope slowly to walk on to the peak of your spiritual life.
一直到今天。
Until today.
我虽然不明白为什么在我们眼前的这个人生阶段中。
Even though at this stage of my life, why is it like this?
为什么苏大嫂得了失智症？
Why my wife had dementia?
而在她得了失智症的同时，我又得经历两次的大肠内窥镜的手术。
And soon after she was diagnosed with dementia, I had to go through two major surgeries.
可是我深深的相信。
But I, in my heart, am deeply convicted.
总有一天，神会让我们明白的。
That one day, God will help me to understand.
但即便我们到最后还是不能明白。
But even if at the end I should not understand all this,
我们现在也已经能够欢欢喜喜地接受这些事情了。
Now already we can face these trials with joy.
因为我们知道，我们两个人的属灵生命都有待磨练。
For you know that all the spiritual life of me and my wife are awaiting training and molding.
所以今天要是有人不明白，我为什么能在苦难中还是这么的欢欢喜喜。
So if there are people yet who do not understand why I can smile so brightly in trials,
我已经能够向他们解释。
I can explain to them.
我为什么笑得那么灿烂。
Why I can smile so brightly.
我就分享到这里。
So I'll share up to this point.
Thank you.